just looks awful. So, in here, yeah? Okay.
The slum is for the poor, the bottom of society. And that's where you are if you're gay.
So how many people live in this room?
Okay, we are five here. Two are sleeping there, one here, and one down with that mattress there. We don't have blankets. We are having that only that one blanket, and others we are using those bed sheets there, which are not enough.
And most can't even turn to their relatives for help.
How many people here have been disowned by their families, and your family doesn't want to see you anymore?
Yeah.
And in that house, that lady, lesbian.
Everybody.
Yeah.
That's unbelievable.
The people in the road.
Area.
Yeah, it's the area. Like me, the most, because of that, I'm gay.
Even my parents, even if I call them, they cannot pick my phone. Even if I call my sister, they hate me. Even my brothers, even my family, any of my family members. So the only family I have are these ones you are seeing here. We feel so sorry to have to that they cannot accept us because that's what we are. We are gays. We are born gays. We shall live gays and we shall die gays.
Well, that was an experience, going to Boise today to see Joseph and his friends. I've never seen anything like that before. The shit, the filth, like babies falling in the shit, like the smell in their room. It was just unbelievable. And the idea that they have to live there because they're gay, because it's the safest place, relatively, is just awful. If you want to see, like, what homophobia does, then just go there because, God, just horrendous, horrendous.
The ongoing prejudice and homophobia in Uganda is stoked by the newspapers, which regularly run stories vilifying and humiliating gays. I know the papers in the UK can be vicious, but there's no way they would contemplate or legally get away with printing what the papers in Uganda have been. Right, so this is the Rolling Stone, the latest edition, which came out only a week or so ago, and with a whole list of people's names outing them as gays. It's not just them, though. This is a paper called The Onion. They're exposing more gay people on the front page again. And this is the latest one. This is Red Pepper, who actually started all this a few years ago, and they're still at it. This is somebody called Stosh. And if you look at the bottom, do you know stuff about Stosh and where she lives? Call us. It's a complete witch hunt. It makes me angry.
I wanted to meet Giles Muhammi, managing editor of The Rolling Stone. He'd been warned about a BBC crew in town and was very twitchy. But after numerous phone calls and waiting around, he agreed to meet us.
Giles?
Hello, Scott.
How are you? Giles. Where do you get the information about the people that you decide to out in the newspaper?
We carried out an investigation for 1 year. We infiltrated their circles. We compiled information from ex-homosexuals. We have so far published about 29 pictures or so.
But is it right that those people have to live in fear now because of what you've printed?
They are telling lies.
So if your name was in the paper, are you telling me that you wouldn't be scared?
I wouldn't be scared.
Are you policing homosexuality?
We are not policing, but we are assisting police to do their work.
What gives you the right to do that?
Because as a newspaper, if you know this, there is evil here. You ignore the right of privacy and smoke out the people so that you can save lives. Homosexuality is very, very dangerous. It reduces one's lifespan by 24 years.
And that's a proven fact?
It's a proven fact.
The Rolling Stone is right behind the proposed anti-homosexuality bill. In particular, the clause saying that in some instances, they should be killed.
You're putting it on the front page of your newspaper that they're bad people and they should be hung.
You see, what they're doing is wrong. So whatever happens to them, the newspaper will never even feel any way bothered.
You don't care?
We do not care. Because what they are doing is not acceptable in society. It's not. We are exposing them. We know there is a cost, there is a price to pay for that. But in the long run, the public will benefit. And that's why the newspaper is there, to serve the interests of the public.
Met Giles today from the Rolling Stone newspaper. I've never met anybody with such absolute hate in their heart for gay people. It's something I've never seen before. But at the same time, he's strangely charming. He's like the silent assassin, do you know what I mean? Smiling as he kills you. Scary, though, because, you know, every day on the front page of his paper, even though it's a small circulation, he'll put homos this, homos that, homos have done this, and it's just whipping up a frenzy of hate, which, you know, I can see why living here and being gay, you'd be really scared. They're going to, you know, put your picture in the paper, put where you live. No one deserves that.
But some people named have fought back. David Kato, who our crew filmed with before I arrived in Uganda, was an activist who won a court case forcing the Rolling Stone to stop printing names. A couple of months later, David was beaten to death in his home with a hammer. Police say he wasn't attacked because he was gay, but his friends aren't convinced. Another person named by the Rolling Stone is a woman called Stosh, who's been outed as a lesbian. She's currently in hiding after being forced out of her old house by a stone-throwing mob.
She has agreed to meet and talk with us on camera, but there's no way we can be spotted going in, so we're going to have to crouch down in a minute so we don't get spotted. Obviously, if they see us, then someone might start asking questions, and then who knows what happened to her.
We're almost here now, but you have to stay down.
OK. Yeah. Coming down the road.
I was pleased to get inside the house without being seen, especially as I could see that Stosh was very nervous. Looking round her bare room, it seemed that Stosh, rather than her attackers, was being punished for what had happened.
It's like a prison, you see, with the gate and the glass and the walls, the bars on the window. It's pretty grim.
I wanted to see where Stosh had been hounded out from, and she bravely agreed to come with us. Although she was clearly scared to go back, and told us there was no way she was getting out of the van.
It started at the internet cafe behind there.
So you were in the internet cafe?
Yeah.
And then people were pointing at you?
Yeah, I'm saying he's the one.
The one in the paper?
Yeah, and then I came after leaving the cafe, passed the shop.
In that shop?
Yeah. And I asked for cigarettes. And then the lady told me, I don't sell cigarettes to people like you. I'm like, why? It's like,
Stosh's neighbours turned on her after seeing her name in the Rolling Stone. She says they were angry a gay person had been living in the area without them knowing.
Somebody threw a stone. When I got back to the gate, they were still yapping. And I was like, how could this happen? These guys, my friends are the ones who started the shouting. This is the gate here.
This is the gate?
Yeah. This one here.
So, Stosh, what's next for you?
You can't stop people from harassing you when they want, but what I know is that in the place I am, at least nobody will just start harassing me, because everybody minds their business, everybody is doing their own stuff. So I'll hang on. It's my life, because what I know is that I'm not going to be scared away from that place again.
This attack is only the latest Stosh has had to endure because she's gay. She wanted to show me her childhood home where, as a teenager, she learned for the first time what being gay in Uganda can really mean.
Before, we would come play hide and seek from the wall, yep. Then we run, come and hide inside. It never used to be something serious. But as a child, you're attracted to someone of the same sex.
So you found yourself being attracted to girls for the first time?
Yeah. And that was, I was a child. Mm.
Stosh attracted the attention of a gardener who noticed she was different from her female cousins.
But this guy would be monitoring what I used to be doing with my cousin sisters. So one time he told me, you know what? I really want to teach you how to play with boys, not with girls. I didn't take it serious until the day, because there was nobody here. And
tell me what happened.
What happened is that this guy, he comes from the other gate. Then all of a sudden, he just held me. He put his hand here. And he just opened my shorts and put his dick inside me. I was a tender person at that time. And that's how it is. Mm. So he was trying to teach me how to sleep with men.
You okay?
Sorry.
Stosh became pregnant and was infected with HIV. And as a result, she tried to commit suicide. The man who attacked Stosh claimed he was trying to cure her of being gay. But whether he thought this or not, there is a strong belief here that people are not born gay, but choose it as a lifestyle, and as such, it can be overcome or even cured. Some people undertake psychotherapy, while others go, or are taken, to churches, where they're counselled by pastors. But there's an altogether more traditional route, and I was about to discover the length some Ugandans go to try and get healed. I'm not scared.
You don't?
I am a little bit. I don't know what they really think about witch doctors over here, but coming from England, I had a bad feeling about it.
First that way.
Oh. Then it was time to begin. But not before I'd crossed his palm with cash. What do I put the money?
They can put it in the judge. Just go like this. You kneel and put it there.
Okay.
But what is your name?
Scott.
Scott.
He's saying that you feel that you are sexually active, but when you start, you finish off so quickly. You don't take long. That will mean that's.
Oh yeah, that's me. Yeah, yeah. Are they laughing at my manhood?
No.
Well, you just laughed.
No. Seriously, throughout in the your heart, in the your spiritual heart.
I'm very sick.
You are sick.
Right.
Yeah. You only think about that thing. So he will work on you and you will be set free.
Okay.
You will set free, then you will be thinking at least also you will get a girlfriend and get married.
Wow.
And have children.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. And I won't think about boys anymore.
No, not anymore.
After the consultation, I was led out to begin the treatment. And that's when I came face to face with my least favourite thing in the world. Oh my God!
No, not from there.
What? Are they gonna? I don't want to touch them.
No problem.
Don't fear.
I don't like chickens. I don't like anything that flaps.
It will not.
It will though. I just saw it flap. It will.